So this is a problem on design of staircase. The problem given is design one of the flights of a stair of a hostel spanning between beams longitudinally to suit the following data. Type of staircase is a waste slab type. Number of steps in one flight is 12, tread is 300 mm, rise is 160 mm, and the width of landing between the beams is 400 mm. And the concrete grade of concrete is M20 and grade of steel is Fe415. So let's start solving this. The first step would be to calculate the effective span. This will be based on the clause number 22.2A of the IS code, so which says that the effective span will be the center to center distance between the end supports. Okay, so in this case the span between the stair is, this is our stair, these are the supports, that is 400 mm. Number of treads is 12, so our going will be 12 multiplied by 300 mm, which is 3600 mm, and the effective span is the center to center distance between the supports. This is our going, 3600, so L effective would be 3600 plus 200 mm from this side and 200 mm from this side, so the effective span would be 4000 mm, which is equal to 4 meters. Now the second step would be to calculate the thickness or the depth of the waste slab. Again, this will be based on the clause number 33.1A using the span by depth ratio, and as this is the simply supported slab, our basic value will be 20. The span by depth ratio will be span upon 20 multiplied by the modification factor. Span is 4000, 20 is the basic value, and modification factor will assume as 1.2. It can be assumed anywhere between 1.2 to 1.5. So it comes to 166.67. Let's take it as 180 mm. So the total depth would be 180 plus, let's assume 10 mm diameter bars. So the half the width of the bar will be 5 mm plus the clear cover is 20. So the total depth is 205 mm. The third step would be to calculate the load acting on the slab. There will be two types of load, dead load and the live load. And in the dead load, there will be three types of load. The first one is floor finish. The second one is the load of the waste slab. And the third one is the load of step, one single step. So first part is dead load. In the dead load calculation, the first is the load of the waste slab. So suppose this is our step, and this is the step, and this is the waste slab. This is the tread and this is the riser. So in the design of staircases, it is assumed that the load is acting horizontally on the waste slab and not inclined. It is assumed to be acting horizontally on the waste slab. So for the calculation load of waste slab, we will multiply the density of concrete, that is 25, by the area of the waste slab, cross sectional area, which is depth multiplied by this part. This is the area, effective area, or the cross sectional area. So this is W, that is, or D, multiplied by this portion, which is under root of r square plus t square. Okay, and we will divide it by t again because we wanted to be acting horizontally. So 25 multiplied by 205 multiplied by under root of 0.205, because this is in kilonewton per meter cube, 0.16 plus 0.3 square upon 0.3, we get 5.8 kilonewton per meter square. The second thing would be to calculate the load of one step. So the load of one step would be this area. Which will be the area of triangle, which is given as half into r into t, and we want it to be acting horizontally, so we will divide it by t. So 0.5 multiplied by 0.16 multiplied by 0.3 upon 0.3, which is equal to 2 kilonewton per meter square. Let's assume a floor finish, the load of floor finish has 0.6 kilonewton per meter square. So if we add all these up, that is 5.8, 2 and 0.6, so therefore total dead load will be 8.4 kilonewton per meter square. The second type of load is a live load. You can take the value of live load from the IS 875, which gives the various values of loads, live loads, dead loads, wind loads, no load, etc. So I'm assuming it as 5 kilonewton per meter. So that's it, and the total dead load was 8.4 kilonewton per meter square. I'm dividing it by 1 meter because for designing slabs we assume the load to be acting per meter width of the slab, and the total load would be 13.4 kilonewton per meter, and I multiplied it by 1.5 because we want the factored load. So this is the factored load, WD. Once you get the load, you can calculate the maximum bending moment. For maximum bending moment, the formula is 0.125 WD multiplied by L effective, which you calculated earlier, squared. This is the formula specially for staircases. This has been derived by drawing the bending moment diagram and the shear force diagrams. So if you want to do that, you can do that too. But the maximum bending moment acts at the center of the staircase, which is given as 0.125 WD L effective square. So 0.125 multiplied by 20.1 multiplied by 4 square, so that is 40.2 kilonewton meter. Now further, the steps would be same what we did for one-way slab. Fourth step is check for depth. So M is equal to 0.36 FCK, XU max B, D minus 0.42 XU max. Now I'll plug all the values here. 40.2 into 10 raised to 6 is equal to, multiplied by 20 is the grade of the concrete, 0.48 D for Fe415 steel, 1000 D minus 0.42 multiplied by 0.48 D. So if we calculate D using calculator, you get 120 mm, which is less than 180 mm, which we assumed earlier. So this is okay. Fifth step would be to calculate the area of tension steel. Our basic formula, which we used for beams. B into D, 0.5 again, 20 415 1 minus under root of 1 minus 4.6, maximum bending moment is 40.2 into 10 raised to 6, 20 into 1000 multiplied by the effective depth, which is 180 square, 1000. Again, the effective depth is 180. So the area of tension steel is 670.73 millimeter square. So once you get this, you can provide the bars. So I'm providing 10 mm bars. So the spacing would be, area of one bar is pi by 4 multiplied by 10 square upon the AST required is 70.73 multiplied by 1 meter, which is in mm. So you get it as 117, which is, let's assume, 115 mm. Okay, then provide the area of distribution steel, which is 0.15 upon 100 into 1000 into 205. This is B and this is capital D. This is given in clause number 26.5.2.1, which is for minimum steel for Fe415. So you get it as 307.5 mm square. Again, now you can provide 8 mm bars. So your spacing would be pi by 4 multiplied by 8 square upon 307.5 into 1000. You get it as 163 mm. Now you can also provide the check for spacing, for maximum spacing. Let's give it in clause number 26.3.3b. Which says it should be either 3D or 300 mm. 3 into D is 3 into 180. So you can multiply 3 into 180, which will be 540, or 300 mm. So in our case, it is 115 mm, so it is okay. So once you get all of this, you can also provide the checks, which will be same as that for one-way slab, which I discussed earlier in my previous videos. So if you want to see that, I'll give a link in the description for that video, or I'll provide a card over here somewhere on the top, so you can check that video by clicking directly on it. I hope you like this video. If you have any doubt, please comment and I'll reply to that. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe.